gas laws. Boyle's law is PV is equal to a constant, K. Boyle did his work with gases using pressure and volume, and he held temperature constant and found out that if you increase pressure on a gas, that the volume decreases. Or if you increase volume, the pressure decreases. And we could think of a balloon maybe to illustrate that. In other words, if one unit goes up, the other goes down. And mathematically, the product of those two is equal to a constant. So here's a balloon of a certain volume. If we were able somehow to apply pressure uniformly to that balloon, we'd concentrate the gases that were on the inside. As the pressure increases, the volume decreases. Charles and Guy Lussac did their work with volume and temperature of gases and held the pressure constant. And the one thing that we have to remember about the Charles and Guy Lussac's law is that temperature must be expressed in Kelvin. We're used to expressing temperature in Fahrenheit or centigrade, and so if you see a problem, don't forget to convert temperature into Kelvins. And in this case, mathematically, if you find two variables which if you increase one, the other increases, or if you decrease one, the other decreases, we express that as a ratio. So again, think of this balloon of a certain volume, and now we're going to decrease the temperature. Maybe we'd put it in the deep freeze. And as these molecules of gas travel around slower and slower and collide with the walls of the balloon less and less, the balloon is going to shrink. In other words, as temperature goes down, volume goes down. We can combine these two gas laws into the combined gas law as PV over T is equal to a constant. And now let's look at a useful form of these gas laws. We can come up with a useful form of the gas laws if we were to vary the conditions and had an initial set of conditions and then a final set of conditions. Because PV over T is equal to a constant, well, this also must be equal to the same constant, or in other words, they're equal to one another. P1 V1 over T1 is equal to P2 V2 over T2. This is my favorite gas law, I suppose, the combined gas law, because if I happen to forget what Boyle's law or Charles' law is, I can always derive them. So for example, Boyle worked at constant temperature. That means that T1 would equal T2, and we could simply eliminate it from this combined equation and come up with P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. This particular equation, well, it's got four variables. If we know three of those, we could solve for the fourth. Or this one up here has six variables. If we know five of those, we can solve for the sixth. If we were working at constant pressure, P1 is equal to P2. Cancels from the equation above, and we have V1 over T1 is equal to V2 over T2. Or we could come up with another gas law and work at constant volume, and V1 and V2 would be equal in that case and would cancel from the equation. We'd have P over T is equal to P over T. Let's work a problem using the gas laws. A toy balloon has a volume of 5.0 liters at 25 degrees centigrade. We've placed that toy balloon in a car, and I guess it's a hot summer day, and as the temperature inside the car increases to 50 degrees centigrade, what would the volume of the balloon be? And we'll assume that pressure stays constant in this case. Well, if I were confronted with this question on an exam, these thoughts would go through my mind. I see lots of numbers. I'd say to myself, math problem. Do I have a formula for it? Well, I see that we're dealing with gases, and so yes, we have a formula. We have the gas laws, and it's like a road map for us. It'll show us how to work the problem. Here's the combined gas law. PV over T is equal to PV over T. Pressure, we're told, stays constant. So we'll eliminate pressure from the equation. We have V over T is equal to V over T. Four variables, we're given information on three of those. We'll be able to solve for the fourth. And the one thing we need to remember is that T must be in kelvins. So the initial volume is 5.0 liters. The initial temperature is 25 degrees centigrade. We'd add that to 273 to get 298 in kelvins. It's V2 that we're after. 50 degrees plus 273 is 323 kelvin. So now we have the equation all set up. The objective always is to get the unknown on one side and all of the numbers on the other side. Maybe you're used to cross multiplying to simplify equations like this, and that'd be great if you like to work the problem that way. I see 323 in the denominator over here, and I know that if I multiply that side of the equation by 323K, it'll cancel and I'll have just V2. If I multiply that side by 323K, I need to multiply this side. And notice that the K's are going to cancel. We're going to get the units liters, which is what we're after, a volume. It's always nice to keep those units in there. If you check the unit and it comes out correctly, chances are your math is correct also. 5.4 liters is the final volume. And notice that it's a little larger than what we started with. And that's what we said about the Charles Gay-Lussac's law, that if the temperature goes up, the volume is going to go up a little also.